We will have a fire drill today. When you hit a home, be ready to go to your business park. If you do not know your spot, please let
me know. Hi, my name is Principal Clark. Our goal at EBR Readiness Middle School is to modify behavior using social-emotional learning and restorative practices. I feel if we don't teach them the correct behavior that's expected of them, when they go back to their home school, we are doing each student a disservice. While each student is at EBR Readiness, we will put a strong emphasis on instruction and curriculum.
What I learned at EBR Readiness is to control my anger and not use it on other people, and to be on my best behavior and work on myself, because if I do be on my best behavior, then it might give me setback to school on my right time, but if I keep getting in trouble, I'm not going back on my regular time and to not use profanity.
EBR Readiness, I learned to make wise decisions and think before I act. Like, think about what the consequences I'm gonna have to go through if I do something. So I learned to make wise decisions and think about what I gotta do.
What I learned at EBR Miss, I learned math, science, English, social studies, and I also learned this is a discipline center. So if you want to go back to your regular school, you got to do good, get good grades, and be respectful.
I learned that sometimes you have to learn how to control yourself better, and that you have to think before you act. And I did learn stuff like school-wise, I'm getting better at math. I was already good at math, but I feel like I just needed to go a little bit slower. And I'm getting better in subjects and all subjects. And my behavior, I think, is also getting better.
So what I learned from EBR Readiness is how to become a better student and do better. And I also learned a lot from being here and how regular school work. And I feel like I'm a better student. I learned how to control my behavior and everything from being here, listening to teachers, and that's it.
What I learned from being at EBR Readiness is that when I come here, I'm supposed to do what I'm supposed to do, and then to get back to my regular school, I gotta do what the teachers tell me to do and have good behavior and do all my work. And then I also learned that when you make good choices, you get good things back, and then you change a lot. To go back to your other school, and then you go back to your other school, and they'll be like, oh, that's a new person. And then, that's what I did.
What I learned from EBR Readiness is how to get on my best behavior and manage my anger issues. And I think that's it.
I'll be over yours. And so, I don't think that's anything we have to dive into deep. We know that this could be a leap-like question. It could be a review of the prior day's activity, or even a part of maybe your anticipatory set or hook to get the students started with that. Let's use that no opt-out technique would be, so how about this? I read one line, you read one line. You want to encourage that student to participate with the class, right? And so we're going to talk about what that looks like in our lesson plan. So just to kind of glance at our agenda for today, we have 4 points we're going to highlight. We're going to talk about how to write those lesson objectives. I will tell you, you did a great job with your objectives.
Some of y'all are going to know everybody. You need a child's interest. This is the Zen room. Do anybody know anything about the Zen room?
Okay.
A chill room? Okay. You can say it's a chill room, but it's not for you to come and play. It's for if you're upset and you need to calm down, de-escalate, if somebody's bothering you, and you need somebody to come talk to, you will come into the Zen room. There's a sign-in sheet on the table over there. You see some people have been coming in already. It's designed for you to stay 5 or 10 minutes, because how long does it take you to calm down when you're mad? 10 minutes? Okay. How long will it take you? 2 minutes to calm down. If you're mad, angry,
you have a common candle that's burning.
And it's all about relaxation and getting your mind off of trouble things. It's always a positive aspect behind it to make you think positive thoughts, okay? Because when you think positive thoughts, you do positive things, right?
Welcome back. We want to find out the cause. What cause? The cause, we're going to find it. Okay? The effects. As a result of it happening, what did the people do? How did it impact the society?
He gets back to her, Grandpa comes right behind him, Grandpa just stops. But you don't know why Grandpa stops. So if you're going back and you remember what happened at the beginning, if you had to go back and redo it, then you'd understand, you'd know more about why the Grandpa stopped.
You get him like that, you feel what I'm saying? So that's one of the basic things I'm trying to make my point. You could get into some schools. Some schools might be different. Now, if y'all move away and go to another school, if y'all stay in Louisiana, this is going to be the ACT. Your core.
You can practice this chart all the time. I want to tell you how important it is. If you really want to learn Spanish, how important it is to know these 10 words. Because honestly, if we look at them, they're kind of baby words. This chart all the time. I want to tell you how important it is. If you really want to learn Spanish, how important it is to know these 10 words. Because honestly, if we look at them, they're kind of baby words. Thank you.
saying that to scare you or to make you nervous or to make you feel overwhelmed in the fact that, oh my God, I already have a good thing to do, right? What it is that we need to be able to rise to the occasion in the profession that we're in. We need to be here to solely and focus on teaching students and growing students. Whether that is Spanish, music, English, science, math, or social studies, physical education. We need to grow students.
Students will only go as far as we think they can go.
Right.
That's it. So if we think that they're more performing, guess what? They're going to perform very well.
And also, for that person, respect yourself enough after working in this environment for 10 years, you have to show respect to people and not to respect you. You have to show respect to each other and not to respect you.
So you
do
not show respect to each other.